As molten rock continues to pool at moderate depths, thousands of earthquakes are simultaneously striking a section of Iceland's highly populated Reykjanes Peninsula. Because of this, some people are concerned that a volcanic eruption might be imminent. Yet, while a volcanic eruption could theoretically be imminent in a stretch of land between northwest of the scenic coastal town of Grindavik and south of the Svartsengi Geothermal Power Plant and the Blue Lagoon, in my opinion, there is still a fairly decent chance that a volcanic eruption won't occur. But before I discuss what is currently occurring at the Reykjanes volcano, which is now on day 17 of its magmatic intrusion, I would like to highlight an interesting find made by the Just Icelandic YouTube channel, who you should subscribe to, by the way. With a thermal drone, in recent weeks he has been checking the vicinity of where the highest land rise is ongoing due to magma pooling at several kilometers depth to see if there have been any changes or new appearances of geothermal features. As, on November 5th, while yet another earthquake swarm was ongoing, he spotted a fairly new series of potential fumarole degassing points, with all of these features either not being present a week ago or showing a much weaker thermal signature back then. This 425-meter-long feature trends perfectly southwest and goes all the way up to one of the work roads at the Svartsengi Geothermal Power Plant. While the first thought that might come to mind for some people is that the increased temperatures at this point must represent where magma is shallowest and thus the most likely spot for an eruption to begin if one were to occur, this is not necessarily the case. As, despite how much we know about the Reykjanes volcano, like many other active volcanoes around the planet, we haven't actually documented where all of its geothermal features are located. As, simply put, small-scale geothermal features can be absurdly common and overlooked for long periods of time without anyone knowing they are there. Case in point, I once helped one of my subscribers discover that they had a small-scale fumarole from the Mauna Loa volcano in Hawaii on their driveway, which they were previously unaware of. Also, sometimes such features naturally and somewhat randomly appear and disappear, or even have a predictable cycle of higher and lower temperatures. Thus, while Just Icelandic's find is interesting, it is far from conclusive as we do not have a detailed baseline to compare it to. So, let us now compare the ongoing magmatic intrusion at the Reykjanes volcano to the four similar intrusions the volcano produced during 2020 and 2022 to see how different or similar the current volcanic unrest is. And, by doing this, I will correct two mistakes I made as I incorrectly stated the depth of the four 2020-2022 magmatic intrusions at the Reykjanes volcano, and incorrectly claimed that the current magmatic intrusion is the shallowest of the five intrusions since 2020 at this volcanic complex. As shown by this chart, the 5 kilometers depth of the current intrusion means that every other of the five intrusions reach shallower points in the crust. However, the ongoing intrusion has involved a greater maximum uplift rate, greater total ground rise, and involved more magma moving into the intrusion, reaching around 7 cubic meters per second. Yet, in the last week, magma does not appear to have reached any shallower in the crust, instead expanding horizontally in what is known as a sill intrusion. Although we do not know the dimensions of the sill, it is probably around 8 kilometers long and could be as much as 200 meters wide. With all of this being said, you might have noted that volcanoes that undergo magmatic intrusions tend to be progressively less likely to eventually erupt with increasing length of the intrusion's duration, although exceptions do exist. As to a claim being circulated that a lava flow could theoretically reach the Blue Lagoon in as little as 3 minutes from the hypothetical eruption's onset, in my opinion this is plausible, but only if an unusually fast lava flow originates within a kilometer of the Blue Lagoon. In other words, we still can't be sure whether Reykjanes is going to erupt or not, but with each increasing day, the likelihood is probably decreasing that an eruption will occur. There is still a double-digit chance, in my opinion, that an eruption will or will not occur, but I would not yet classify either scenario as a certainty. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's new YouTube channel member, Jim Brew, for supporting this channel.